He's saying, are you going to listen to what the word is saying? So what's in the word? How to live, how to eat, how to rest, how to do everything. Come that you might have life and have life what? More abundantly. Then come for you to be stressed out. Then come for you to be poor. Then come for you to die early. Then come for that. I came for you that you might have what? Life and have it more abundantly. Then he lets us know, now you do have enemies. They'll try and pluck you out of my hand, but I will not allow it. So when the enemy comes, when he shows up, what am I to do? You better take some word, get some more word. Why would I get the opinion of my so-and-so and broke Uncle Bob over here? You better think what they said. No. You better get the word. Hallelujah. To finish reading that, Proverbs 4:20, read to verse 22 if you will, please.
They are like it for those that find them.
The life to all those that find it, and the health to all of their flesh. I got the eternal life out of the word. How do I know that I have a word? Colossians 3:16 says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching you all wisdom and giving you good understanding. Let the word of Christ dwell in you. Now the enemy, his job, even though we studied in Sunday school this morning, thou shalt not eat of the tree in that garden. He said to Adam. And then the devil taps Eve on the shoulder. What did God say about that tree? And Eve says, well, he said we can't eat it and we can't touch it either. And he asked, well, let's turn back. What did God say about that tree? He says, don't eat it. And then we turn over there and say, Eve, what did God say about that tree? We can't eat it and we can't touch it. What was Eve's problem? She didn't know what the word said. He never said you can't touch that tree. He said you can't eat of it. So here's Eve in her hour of temptation. Here comes the devil. He's got a load of goodies for you. Sickness, disease, death.
Yes.
He's got a whole bunch of stuff for you. And in your hour of temptation, in your hour of test, your hour of trial, can you say, by his stripes, I'm what?
Healed.
Can you say it with meaning? And I mean that. By his stripes, I am healed. Get thee behind me, Satan.
Yeah.
Jesus in his hour of temptation is very weak. 40 days haven't eaten. And well, turn this stone into bread. Jesus knew the word. It is written. He knew the word. And he put the word on the temptation. He put the word on the devil. And he come away victorious. That's what you and I have to do. My son, attend to my words. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Let the words. Because Jesus says, I am the life. And we've got to let his words dwell in us so we can put them on the situation and the circumstances, all the negative stuff that come up. I should have got arousing. Should have got an offering. Psalms 119:9-11. Here's what he says. How can I straighten out my life? How can a young man, young person, young anybody, how can I straighten out my life? Psalms 119, I believe it's verse 9. It says, anybody got that already? Read it for me if you will.
Taking heed thereunto according to your word.
Read through verse 11.
With my whole heart have I sought you. Oh, let me not wander from your commandments. Your word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you.
Your words have I hid in my heart. How can a young man clean his way? How can they do it? How can I be victorious on this earth? It's the word of God. You got to take it. You got to digest it. You got to get yourself full of it. Now, here's the reality. God is no respecter of what person. He don't care who you are. Hallelujah. He don't care who you are. He's kind of like money. Money don't care who you are. Glory to God. He knows that you're spending it with who. They don't care who you are either. As long as you got what? The money. While we was on vacation, we can get whatever we want to do. Sit down, room service 3 or 4 times a day. You get your glass halfway empty, they fill it right back up. You got the money. They got the money. They can pay. They don't care. We don't care. Hallelujah. This is what he says, abundant. Say, we got to get to the reality that our God is a God of abundance. Here's the reality. I'm going to see Ephesians 3:20. Above all that you can think or ask. That's the kind of God you got. Above all that you can think or ask. You can't ask for too much. Talked this morning about mercy. How much mercy does he have? How much do you need? How much grace? He's able to make all of it do what? Abound toward you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How much do you want? How much do you need? Some folks are listening to the other sounds and say, well, if I just get just a little bit, just guarantee me that when I pass from this life, I'll wound up in heaven. Well, okay, that's all you want. That's all you get. So what do you mean, Brother Williams? Because I'm thinking right now, Mark 11:23-24. That's whatever you ask. Or whatever you ask, believing, you get. The woman that with the issue of blood, she says, if I just touch him of his garment, I'll be made whole. What do you want? I want to touch his garment. So I'll be made whole. Now, some of us in here, we need to touch him so I can be well. So I can come out of the poorhouse. So I can be worry free. Hallelujah. So my house can be saved. How much do you want? That's what he said, that your joy might be full. Hallelujah. Not according to someone else's, but yours. What do you want? So that your joy might be full. And someone said, praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. That's about all I have to say, praise God. Can we digest that? Can we nourish the word? Praise God. Next time, mash the tables. Next time. I think the word is more important. Yes. Hallelujah. Glory to God. How can I win over my enemies tomorrow? Pick up the word tonight and be prepared for the battle tomorrow. Look at the word tonight and get prepared for the report tomorrow. Isaiah 53, who shall believe this report? And to whom is the womb of the Lord revealed? He was wounded for our transgressions. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we are what? Healed. Who believes that report? Hallelujah. Who will believe that report? That's the man, the woman that's going to walk through the trials and afflictions, going to walk through anything that life brings in way because I have another belief system. Hallelujah. Thank you, Doc, for your report, but I got another one to look at. Hallelujah. Thank you, Mr. Financial Officer, on this wrong report, great report of mine, but I got another one to do what? Look at it. I got another one to consider. Hallelujah. Bring me all your reports, but they got to outweigh this one. He loved me so much that he died for me. He said, he loved me so much that he didn't let no one take his life. He says, I'm going to lay it down for you, and then I'm going to bring it back up again. Hallelujah. And if you will abide in me and my words abide in you, you can do what? Ask. That's how we were on vacation. Whatever we wanted, just what? Ask. Ask. And knocked on our door when we wasn't wanting them to. Can we do it? Can we turn your bed back? Yeah, come on. Can we stop your refrigerator? Yeah, come on. What do you want to do? What do you want to do?